But God, you didn't snatch my word. You didn't. Have you ever left church and then somebody asked you 2 hours later, what was the sermon about? And you go, it talked about sin. What did he say about it? I think he was against it. Say that mind coming in and snatching every word from you. That's why we encourage you to come to Bible study. Some of us feel like we know enough. All we got to do is get there for the preacher's sermon, that's it. Never come to Bible study. Never come to Wednesday morning, Wednesday night. All we need is a prayer. And don't be too long when you're up there preaching either. We'll sit there and watch a football game for 2.5 hours. And lose our voice, get mad, and enjoy the movie. We'll go to a 2.5 hour movie to watch sin. We won't have no problem. We'll watch the old and the time, I mean Young and the Restless, all day. And won't blink an eye, won't move for a water break. But preacher, don't you get there too long. Let's get done in 35 minutes. Let's get out of here. Bible goes on to say, he says, give me the parable of the sword. When one hears the word of the kingdom, understand it not, and become a wicked one, catching away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which received seed by the wayside. Verse 20. But he that received the seed into the stony place, the same is he that heareth the word, and anon immediately with joy he receiveth it. See, that's a different kind of soul. See, some of us will hear the word of God for the first time and it sounds so good, we get so excited about it. Oh, I'm going to be a Christian for the rest of my life. I love the Lord. I want to do without the Lord. As soon as the tambourine stops playing, as soon as the band goes home, as soon as the light show is turned off, as soon as the microphones are shut down, you got to deal with life. That's why, brothers and sisters, I have pledged my life not to preach cotton candy sermons. 1 o'clock, you get out here and be more excited, man. You got to, and the Lord, ain't he good? Yes, he's good. We serve a good God. I can do that if I wanted to, praise God. But I'm not here for theatrics. I got to meet the Lord, too. And I'm going to lead him preaching his word. You might not like it. You might not even come back. You might get upset with me, but that's fine. Because the Lord didn't say, go ye and make friends. Last I read, he said, go ye there and make disciples. My desire is to preach the word of God without fear or without stuttering. So I stand flat-footed and firm when it comes to this word of God. I'll come and find somewhere else. You want to go to McDonald's? That's cool. I really like Burger King, but I don't. You want to go to Simpsons? No, I'm going to rent red button. You want to go to Simpsons? But when it comes to the word of God, I'm not compromising. I'm not compromising, brothers and sisters. And the sad fact is, we got so many brothers that are. Lord says, look at this. We're almost done. He says, verse 21. Same person that gets happy, he receives the word with joy, yet he has no root in himself. In other words, he receives it, but because he is not studying, because he is not constantly in prayer, because he does not allow the Lord to illuminate the word of God in his heart, guess what happens? Guess what happens? The Bible says, but do it for a while. For when tribulation or persecution arises, because of the word, by and by, he is offended. The word is scandalizo in the Greek. It means he stumbles at the word of God. We got a lot of stumbling Christians. I don't know if you've noticed. We got a lot of Christians who talk about things that are controversial today. You know, they talk about everything else. I'm so tired of that. 45. I'm so tired of this. I'm so tired of that. We need this. We need that. Jesus and hold on, brother, I don't talk about religion and politics. But you've been talking about everything else. Aren't you a disciple? Aren't you? Yeah, brother, you gotta be careful nowadays. You want to offend people. We live in a time and age where everybody's offended. I got brown shoes on today. You know, Brother Clark, I just don't like brown shoes, Brother Clark. I'm sorry. And you know, that just remind me of now my childhood. I got hit by a brown car. I just don't like brown shoes. Brother Clark, you spelled my name wrong today. You just hurt me. I thought you knew my name. How you spelled my name? You just, Brother Clark. Oh, Brother Clark, I appreciate what y'all served today, but you know, I'm a vegetarian. I'm offended that y'all. You can't even say anything to anybody when you get upset. I'm not exaggerating. People are offended. Bible says you're going to be hated by all of them. You want to be a disciple of Christ, get ready. Get ready. If you want to love, you're in the wrong business. If you want people to love you, amen. Be a politician. I don't know. Be a comedian. But you can't be a child of God. You got to be ready for a fight as a child of God, and not a physical fight. People don't get upset. And brothers and sisters, we are rapidly getting to the point in our world, not just our nation, where Christianity is going to be so despised, they're going to throw you in jail. As we speak, there's a gay parade going on downtown Atlanta. You best believe that not one Christian go down there and tell them they're wrong. But if I drive through there and they come to my window and say, you want to join? I'm going to say, no. Bible says you should not lie to a man like a woman. I'm going to tell you, not out of hate, not out of judgment, but I'm going to tell you because this is the word of God. You gotta lighten up, you gotta walk softly over there because you don't understand. This is the world we live in now. We have to change. And how young people are looking at us. Mama's not saying anything about it anymore. Parents are saying, well, baby, I love you. Nothing wrong with loving. I'm not saying don't love your child. Because we all have struggles. We struggle with sin all the time. That's just one sin out of many.
Amen.
But if you're not gonna do it, you're going to have John and Luke at your house for Thanksgiving and then say, well, it's okay, I support you. I love you, but I'm not going to support you. See, that kind of preaching, that won't get you invitations. Matter of fact, some people right now are offended. I see some faces tightening up as I say that right now. My best friend is gay. I love
you.
But I want to face Jesus in peace. And you won't do it. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor whoremongers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. None of these will inherit the kingdom of God. Now you can say, well, Brother Clark, that was old time. It's still the word of God. And if you're a Christian, that's what God's will is. See, we don't put a pause button and say, well, we didn't do what you want to do. Okay, let's hit play. You're a Christian all the time. You're a disciple. You're a disciple all the time. Let me finish. The Bible goes on to say, the third person, he also that received the seed among thorns, is he that heareth the word and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches. He says that chokes the word of God. You know, it's interesting. Some people will hear the word of God, allow the word of God to germinate in their heart. But guess what happens to them? And this is something that happens to most Christians, a lot of Christians, I should say. We allow the word of God to be choked. It means we didn't receive it. Doesn't mean we didn't get it originally, but we allow the word of God to be choked. That imagery is like you being strangled by somebody. They've got their hands around your throat and you can't breathe. You want to breathe, but you can't. Why? Because you're getting choked. Watch what the Bible says. The Bible says, the thorns. Ram, hold that person, begins to choke them. The riches of this world, what can I do to make money? What can I do to have pleasure in this life? I'm young. I got a coat shape. I got a good job. I don't really need Jesus right now. But let me get old and then I'll check back in. Let me use all my energy, my youth energy for me. Let me express myself. Let me do my thing. You know how I would say it. Let me do my thing. And guess what? Every time you breathe in and breathe out, you're closer to not breathing at all. And I'm not here to scare you. You might live another 50 years, 100 years. God bless you. But you know how fast 100 years is an eternity? Not even a half a second. Let me tell you what your life looks like. Use this pew. Your life is like right in the corner, and that's eternity on that way. So guess what? You can walk now. You can live. You will live forever. Hallelujah. Ain't that just enough?
Amen.
When I have funerals, I've done a few, when we do funerals, it's sad only because we won't see her on this side. What do you mean we won't see her? It just means on this side. But when you die, guess what's going on the other side? Oh, they're living. Amen. Now, how excited or how depressed depends on what they did on this side. They were Jesus, they're the happiest things in the world. That's why it's not a sad day when people die in the world. The Bible tells me that I believe it. See, we don't mourn like those who don't have hope. See, we don't mourn. The Bible says you don't have to mourn. This says we don't mourn like those who don't have hope. Cry all you want. Because that's going to hurt. It's going to hurt when sister leaves you. It's going to hurt when brother leaves. It's going to hurt when mama leaves. It's going to hurt when dad leaves. But we don't mourn like those who don't have hope. We don't mourn because we have hope. Now, you won't have hope unless you're in Christ. You gotta be in Christ. And that brings me to the last seed. Look at verse 23. But he that receiveth seed into good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it. We mentioned this word before. In the Greek is a word called sunomeia. It basically means you put things together. You put the word of God together almost like a puzzle and you can see it clearly now. He says, once you do that, you understand it. And when you understand, you bear fruit. And when you bear fruit, you bring some 30-fold, some 60-fold, some 100-fold. In other words, it's impossible to be a real disciple of Jesus and not bear fruit.
Amen.
Scary thought? Let this sink in 2 seconds. Let's sink in. It's impossible to be a true disciple of Jesus. Yeah. What's the converse? Well, I'm a disciple, Brother Clark, and I haven't brought anybody to Christ. I know you called me. We got an opportunity, Lord willing, to bring people to Christ, to hear the word of God and answer. Let's do it. Let's bear fruit. Because brothers and sisters, whether we know it or not, the Lord says, you all must bear fruit. You all must bear fruit. That's what fruit does. It bears itself. If you got an apple tree and that thing starts to grow watermelons, get rid of it. Quick. I believe it. An apple tree should, Kelly, am I lying? An apple tree should bear what? Apples, right? The disciples, they don't look because the disciple looks like Jesus. And so you need to be like Jesus, a Christian, because you're like Jesus and you bear fruit that looks like the one you looking like. If you're not bearing what you look like, maybe it's because you don't look like the fruit you're supposed to be bearing. Well, I'm preaching better than y'all talking. You better understand. Time is rapidly running out. Whether you want to believe it or not, I tell you, you can take all the GNC brackets you want. You can get in that gym another 4 hours if you want. You can get Botox on the eyes. Amen. You get liposuction. Amen. You can do all that, and God bless you if you do. You look good, you know, I want y'all looking like y'all smiling when you're sad, though. Whatever you do, just realize they might put you 6 feet deep one day. God says, you look at you. Brothers and sisters, I said enough. How do you become part of this hope? How do you become part of the body of Christ? The Bible says, he that believeth in your heart and is baptized shall be saved. Brother, I've been baptized before. I've been baptized in various churches. Listen, listen. The Bible makes specific why you should be baptized. Some people are baptized because it's an outward sign of their grace. On baptism. Some people are baptized because they said, it's my Christian name. On baptism. Some people say baptism just basically makes you're a member first and then you're baptized later. Wrong doctrine. The Bible says you are baptized for a purpose clause, remission of your sins. So if you're been baptized for remission of your sins, and added to his body, not the other bodies you used to be a part of, then you're not part of his body. Do you see what I'm saying? I work for a particular company. If I go to another company, work all day, and then at the end of the week say, where's my check? They don't need a check. You know why? Because I don't work for that company. I can do the same amount of work I do for my company. But because I don't work for them, guess what? I don't get a check from them either. Get in God's kingdom. He that believeth and is baptized. The Bible says you must hear the word of God, believe with your heart. Confess Jesus. Let people know, I confess Jesus. And change your mind. That's all it means. Just change your mind. When you change your mind, God will change your state. Change your mind. And go down to the water and river baptism and be baptized and added to his body. There's nothing magical in the water. But the Lord said, do it. And the Lord says, do it. And you say not to do it, guess what? I'm going to go with the Lord. Well, I can say, come into my heart. I believe Jesus already. I don't need to be baptized. The Lord says, he that believes then is baptized. And of course, that injunction being the first thing is just the power of the second thing. He says, repent. Shirt and shoes. Amen. Amen. You got to eat and swallow to be full. Amen. Well, I ate, I ain't swallowed. We understand this when it comes to life, but when it comes to the word of God, we're going to fight it. Brothers and sisters, if you're here today, you're not a member of the Lord's church, only church you read by the Bible, I implore you this morning as we stand and sing the song of invitation. Come to Jesus this morning. Come to him right now. Come to him.